Thank you for this day, Lord. And thank you for having the freedom and to live in this beautiful country. Father God, we are just blessed to live right here in the Ozarks, where it's just gorgeous. And fall's fixing to happen, all the leaves are turning, and it is just so beautiful here. And Father God, we ask you to lift up our president and his wife, Lord, and his whole family. Father God, we ask you to lift up our government, Father God, and let them pull their heads up and let them get busy on what's good for us and not for them, Father God. And we just thank you. And we are standing that they're going to make the right decisions, Father God, for us. And Lord, we ask you to lift up the beautiful passion play, Lord. Just keep on sending the people coming, Lord. And Father God, we lift up the churches, Lord. Yes. And we ask you just to put your Holy Spirit on them, Lord, and open up their eyes and let them show how awesome you are, Lord. And Father God, we just love you so much and we thank you for this day. And Lord, we ask you to take us completely out, that we give you all the praise and glory. It is not about us, Father God. It is about you. And we love you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And I'm sorry when my eyes close, I won't get by, I might end up on your lap. I'm sorry, just give me a push. Well, we had a real busy week. Yeah, as always. And things are just getting busier. And the need, we've really noticed that the need is really picked up, and man, we are so blessed that the Lord just loads us up with so much stuff that we get to load people up pretty good, you know, and it's a blessing. I mean, we can't give stuff away fast enough, man. That's how our God works.
Amen. Amen.
Loads on them blessings, and man, we had the, just like every week, we're stomping on our freezers, trying to get them shut. And there's like 9 freezers in this place, and they're all like full. So, well, not so full now since Friday.
We gave a lot of food.
Yeah, and I'll let my bride.
Well, we're inside today, and we're hoping that we can continue that.
It's gonna happen.
We've got some construction that's going on, and we need to finish that up and kind of get, so we are blessed and thankful for those that are doing that for us. And also, I want to say thank you to the volunteers that are here and that are able to be here as much as they can. And we can't do this without you. And also the help with the finances and those that help us out, keeping the doors open and everything. We're so blessed. God just keeps pouring out. And so this week we were able to help 113 families. That was 436 people.
Wow.
I don't get everybody's names, a lot of the new ones. We're trying to put them all in the computer and everything, so it's kind of, we have to have everybody fill out the little slip. That way I know if I can get them on the computer and everything.
I'll just tell you
and
the truth.
And it's mainly just for numbers, not your name. Yeah. It's mainly just for your numbers and how many you have in your family. So we know how much to order for the following week. Because we expect once they come, they'll be coming for the next week. So we'll do that this afternoon. Don't worry. Okay. So I just want to say thank you for those that come and help. And we are going to continue handing out food every day.
Yes.
Don't go without. If you need food and you come in, as long as we have it, we are passing it out. So
amen.
We're not going to limit anybody to anything like that. So no worries on that part. So also we've had some donations of some stuff come in. And so we're trying to bless others with it. And then we had
We had a 3-sided carport donated to us.
Praise
so
the Lord.
We're carport out there. And we what we're gonna do, we're gonna put it down there and block this off, and I'm gonna get it. I know a basketball goal.
And this will be a safe spot for kids to play.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Yep, blessing, blessing, right there.
Stop the driving through that way, and we'll continue it this way. But we are still gonna serve throughout the week outdoors.
Until I get, I'm out.
Keep it out of his way, I can hear.
I keep saying that.
Just pray for strength and all that. The other day, Chuck and I went and
took that cardboard.
Oh, yes. That's hard work, yeah.
I got stabbed.
Thomas went with us, thank you, Thomas. He's not here today, cause he's probably some bit.
We worked hard.
But, we did have some prayer requests this morning. Brad and his family, keep them lifted up. Like you said, the president and his family, we need to be praying for our leaders. No matter who they are, no matter what your views are, you need to pray for your leaders.
Amen.
No matter what.
No matter what, they're the ones that are, yes. And then Thomas and Terry, Thomas that helped us yesterday, and Terry, their brother and sister, their, one of their brothers passed away. He had cancer, severe nursing home, so he passed away this last week. But they're traveling this weekend, but I think today or maybe this next week.
And they will be with COVID.
But, but let's just keep him lifted up. He is a huge part, they are a huge part of our family. Also, my sister from Texas, she asked for a prayer personally for her family and herself, and so I just want to lift up all my family.
JR and Becky.
All of our volunteers, our church, our congregation, everybody that is here, please keep them in your prayers. Everyone that's not here, please keep them in your prayers as well. And then we did have a lady that used to volunteer, her and her husband, her son, used to help us out when we first opened up. She passed away from cancer, and he is without his mom.
Oh.
The family came and got him, so they're taking him to a whole different place, but starting completely over, so it's a little shock for him.
He's kind of a special need.
So please keep him in your prayers. First name is Dan. But just keep him with it out.
And we had a lot of deaths happen here lately, and a lot of people that have got stupid cancer lately, and I hate that cancer. I mean it. I just, yes, and Bob Ballinger and his family, we lift him up, and we just, man, we need to pray for healings on that. Just keep that in your prayers, because it seems like no matter what family, nobody escapes it. You know, somebody in their family gets it, and either they recover or sometimes they don't, you know. And you know, it's hard for us to understand that, and you gotta realize that God's in control no matter what. Even though when we are get a little angry and don't understand why that person got taken away from us, we gotta just remember that the Lord knows what's going on, you know, and it's His will, not ours.
Amen.
So, with that, oh, I gotta tell you what we're getting ready to start doing, hopefully within the month. We're gonna, on Tuesday nights, we're gonna be interviewing other ministries and pastors and just people in general, giving their testimonies of what the Lord has done for them. And, you know, it's not, that's one thing that I do want to mention, and it's hard and it's easy to get caught up in. When you give your testimony, yeah, you had all that crap you had to go through, but don't dwell on that, man. Dwell on what the Lord's done for you.
Amen.
Look at where you are now. Compared to what you were, you know, and it will really help your mindset and everything to get rid of the victim mentality, because that's what it kind of becomes. Mm-hmm. And I've been guilty of it many a times, you know. It's like, oh man, if I wouldn't have been a drug addict, I wouldn't have this and that wrong with me, you know. And I'm healed. I have no hep C.
Hallelujah.
No liver.
Amen. Yeah, thank you, Lord.
That's all the Lord.
Amen.
And I'm just here to tell you that God is awesome. So we're going to play some praise and worship music. And we're going to just do it over here.
We're really winging it today, aren't we, baby?
Whatever songs we're doing, that's what we're doing.
I don't even know.
Hey, well, that's good. We'll just
Open the mouth, Andy. We'll follow along.
So what's new?
Yeah. Next week will be up there, hopefully.
We'll just follow with the hallelujahs.
There you go. There you go.
Feel free to praise God.
My husband has an app on his phone that listens for 10 seconds and he gets your lyrics. And call it. Yes, it's called Genius Lyrics.
Okay.
And it's free.
Awesome.
But it just has to, just 10 seconds. And it gives you the lyrics, name of the song, and the lyrics.
Cool. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
He's trying.
So we'll
start off with
a couple, maybe three weeks ago. That's there's something about that name.
Ooh, hey, that's that's a good.
Amazing Love, this old one that we haven't done in a long time, I think.
Thank you.
brethren saw. Let my words be few for those who want to look up here. You're a God in heaven, and here am I on earth. So I'll let my words be you. Jesus, I am so in love with you. I think I'll be done after that. Is that okay? This one we did during communion last time here, and it's a great song to remind ourselves here of what it's all about. Thank you.
Bible's right up there, sorry, everybody.
Lovely wife, we're going to trade off reading, and the next one, if you want to know, just kind of put your finger in, you have to get a heads up, there's 2 Corinthians chapter 3, so kind of put your finger there, I'll give you time to read. I'll let you get to James. Thank you. And this is just, man, God is awesome. That's all I got to say. Woo, thank you, Father God. All right. Everybody there?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Man. Hey, I gotta ask you, when you came in and you see nobody out there, did you think, man, will the rapture come? I'm just like,
and there was a lot of cars, and I looked over and I said, there in some.
I thought we were here early, and it was like after 10, I'm thinking,
something ain't right.
All raptured.
Right, here we go. I'm sorry. That was a good funny. Okay, here we go. James chapter 1. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes scattered among the nations, greetings. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance.
Amen.
Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything.
Amen.
If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and know and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. Believers in humble circumstances ought to take pride in their high positions, but the rich should take pride in their humility, since they will pass away like a wildflower. For the sun rises in scorching heat and withers the plant, its blossom falls and its beauty is destroyed. In the same way, the rich will fade away even while they go about their business. Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him.
Amen.
Can I get a woo-hoo?
Yeah.
Amen. When tempted, no one should say, listen to this very carefully. When tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone.
That's right.
But each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desires and enticed. Then after desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full grown, gives birth to death. Don't be deceived, my dear brothers and sisters. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. He chose to give us birth through the word of the truth, that we might be a kind of first fruits of all he created. Man, I love this. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. Well, we could all kind of take that test, huh? Woo. Because human anger does not produce the righteousness that God desires. Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word planted in you, which can save you. Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. Anyone who listens to the word but not do what it says, it's like someone who looks at his face in a mirror and after looking at himself goes away and immediately forgets what he looks like. But whoever looks intently into the perfect law that gives freedom and continues in it, not forgetting have heard, but doing it. They will be blessed in what they do. Those who consider themselves religious and yet do not keep a tight rein of their tongues deceive themselves, and their religion is worthless. Religion that God our Father accepts as pure and faultless is this: to look after orphans and widows in their distress and to keep oneself from being polluted by the world.
Amen.
Amen. All right, we're going to go to 2 Corinthians chapter 3. I'm going to let my beautiful bride read a little bit. I don't want to know more. I love you guys.
Wait.
Ourselves
again. Let everybody get there. Sorry.
You're
like one of the bad
pictures
now. Yeah.
Is that coffee?
Let's go to
Woodcreek.
Okay,
yeah. Everybody there? Close to it? Nope. All right. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Yes.
So are we beginning to commend ourselves again, or do we leave, like some people, letters of recommendation to you or from you? You yourselves are our letter, written on your hearts, known and read by everyone. You show that you are a letter from Christ, the result of our ministry, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. Not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human heart.
Yeah.
Such confidence we have through Christ before God. Not that we are competent in ourselves to claim anything for ourselves, but our competence can, and it comes from God. He has made us competent as ministers of a new covenant. Not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Now, if the ministry that brought death, which was engraved in letters on stone, came with glory, so that the Israelites could not look steadily at the face of Moses, because of its glory, transitory though it was, will not the ministry of the Spirit be even more glorious? If the ministry that brought condemnation was glorious, how much more glorious is the ministry that brings righteousness? For what was glorious has no glory now in comparison with the surpassing glory. And if what is transitory came with glory, how much greater is the glory of that which lasts?
We had to look up some of these words. We had to read them over and over. I'm like, man, I'm going to make her read it.
That's why I look at him.
I love you.
Therefore, since we have such a hope, we are very bold. We are not like Moses, who would put a veil over his face to prevent the Israelites from seeing the end of what was passing away. But their minds remained dull. For to this day, the same veil remains when the old covenant is read. It has not been removed, because only in Christ is it taken away. Even to this day, when Moses is read, a veil covers their hearts. But whenever anyone turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away. Now the Lord is the Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Amen.
And we all, who with unveiled faces contemplate the Lord's glory, are being transformed into his image with ever-increasing glory, which comes from the Lord, who is
the Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Right there. Thank you, Father God, for the word, Lord. Let us use this word and in our daily walk, and let us get closer to you, Father God. And just let us just hunger for your word, Lord, and not get enough. Thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. what it really said a lot to me reading all this, and I just, man, you know, we all have trials, and it just to test our faith. And like I've told you over and over, if you don't pass that trial, you're going to get it again.
That's right.
Come back around. So, and you just ask the Lord for strength, you know, and to learn from that trial and get on with it. That's a thing, you know, because you can sit there and go, oh, man, and stumble right back into the same crap you just got tested on, man. It'll just keep coming around and around and around until you finally get it. And you will get it. You just, and this is the main thing, you know. I pray this all the time. Ask God for wisdom.
Yes.
And if you truly repent and turn from sin, man, I'm telling you, God's going to look at that, I guess you'd say, righteousness, and he's going to bless you, and he's going to answer your prayers. He will give you wisdom that when you read the Bible, it will make sense to you. You know, and I know that's pretty hard, and I've been in the book of Daniel, and I've just got to Hosea, and man, you need to really be asking for wisdom when you read those books, because it's a trip, and what's so crazy is how it's all been, it's happened.
Yes.
I mean, wow. And beside this, you know, I know this isn't in on the deal, but man, what just blows my mind is ever since Israel has became a state, that has been prophecy started right then.
Amen.
And the Lord says that then people, that generation, will not pass before the Lord comes.
So, hallelujah.
Man, that's awesome. That could be another 10, 20 years. Some people live 100 years old, you know. But,
could
yeah,
be tomorrow.
Just get ready. But, and, you know, what really got me is if, when you pray for wisdom and when you pray for things, don't get that doubt out of your mind. Get it out. Because, and I'm guilty of this too. I'll be praying and it's like, oh, but he's not going to answer that. Or, you know, that's just too big of a thing to ask for. No. You just get rid of that doubt. And it'll take a while for you to quit doing that to yourself. And get stronger, you know, and just be praying and say, Lord, you know, every time that pops into my head, doubt and disbelief, because, man, you know how Satan is, man. He'll be saying, oh, you know, that's all right, remember that, you know, you can't be doing this. You're not really forgiving, blah, blah, blah. He's a liar.
That's
he's
right.
Always going to be whispering, chattering in your ear until you finally just say, every time that chatter starts, man, you cut it off. Say, them are not my thoughts, and this is not what I believe, so just get away from me. Done it, did it, been there, done it. Get out of here. You know?
Amen.
And, yeah, and like I always say, he's going to always tempt you with the same old crap all the time. It's always, it's not going to be nothing new and different. It's always the same thing over and over. You know, and that's another thing that I really want you to get out of what we've read. God does not tempt us.
Amen.
God, you know, that is the evil one trying to tempt you, to get you to do something, and he wants to mess you up. And believe me, I fell before. I have backslidden, and man, he's going to do it until you're backslidden all the way back and then some. And man, it's a lot harder when you come back to get back on them feet, because it's like being a drug addict. You seem like you never get that high again. So you're always chasing it. So it's like, man, I want that Holy Spirit back in me like I first had.
Yeah.
You know? And guess what? He gives it to you.
Amen.
You just got to get that crap out of there, you know, and just say, okay, I'm not going to do that no more. I get it, you know. and just study on the Word. And man, read this book. Take time. I mean, I know we're all busy. We are. And sometimes we sit around and do stuff that we shouldn't be doing. We should be reading our Bible. I'm guilty of that. Me and stupid YouTube. I've got.
It's like, well, let's see what they're saying today.
It's crazy. But and you got to be careful of that because there's a lot of crazy people.
Some weird stuff.
Ask for wisdom and discernment because you'll get it. It's like, no, I don't want to believe that. Please, you know? And so, anyways, just use that discernment. Yes, sir.
Can I share something?
Yeah.
Testimony. And just a little piece to go.
And what's your name?
Eric Downs.
Right.
Yes, I'm an evangelist preacher, like my daddy. And my dad, when he started off, he went to blind school, and he never went to regular school. He learned to read to the Bible. He actually, and some of the little books, my older brothers, that they came home from school in grade school, and my mother started helping him. But God gave him his sight back. God healed him.
Amen.
He gave him his sight back, and he went to blind school. he knew Braille, and so he learned to read to this Bible. You know, and God just showed him.
Awesome.
And through that engrafting of the Word, and we're thinking about that. And my wife, she's a good teacher. She's very good teacher. She taught a message at Bible study one time, and it brought this message back home. And when we talk about this scripture, it says, "Wherefore laying apart all filthiness and superstition and of naughtiness, and receive the meekness, the engrafting word, which is able to save the soul." She gave a message on the body, the soul, and the spirit. And when you get saved, the body will be resurrected. It will be saved. So your body's going to be saved, and the spirit that moves inside you once you give your life to Jesus, it's going to be saved. It's saved automatically once you gave your life to the Lord. But the soul, she gave this message on the soul, and it says here, by the engrafting of God's word, the soul is able to be saved too. The thing is, the soul is where all your pain is, all your hurt and sorrow, all the bad things that's ever happened to you, all the people that stabbed you in the back and lied and cheated and done you dirty, and how you lived your life, the lack of love that people showed you in your life, that drug you down to where you was to do drugs or living on the street or whatever it may be, that's your soul. And your soul is able to be saved by the engrafting of his word. It can be set free. He says he gives us freedom, right? He says, but don't use it for yourself. Use it to serve one another in love. He says, the kingdom of God is within inside of us now. We can live in that freedom of the kingdom of God, which is inside of us, by the engrafting of this word. And that engrafting is joining. I mean, it's mending to you. The more that you read it and you soak it in, it'll set you free from all that stuff that's in your soul.
Amen.
So your soul can be saved by the engrafting.
Amen.
Thank you,
brother.
Amen. Amen.
Just like you said, you know, it's a letter written on your heart, not in ink on a tablet. It's in your heart, you know. And we, the Holy Spirit, it is the Lord.
Yes.
And so, when you leave, and the Holy Spirit, and you know, this is something you gotta kind of be careful, but just do it and see your life change. Ask for the Holy Spirit to come into your life. And let me tell you, he will. Because he's going to slap you in the head, you know, and say, hey, that's not right. Stay away from that. Don't you do that. You go apologize to them. You do whatever, you know. And you listen to that. But, you know, pray for the Holy Spirit to live inside you.
Yes.
And just open your eyes and your heart. And I know my bride, always
got something to say. Scriptures to read to you so you would know how blessed you are through Christ. blesses us so we can bless others.
Yes.
Financially, amen. Yes, material. But I think he blesses us more spiritually so we can bless others.
Amen.
So your light that you have, that you walk in and a transcending light. I just feel like the Holy Spirit, you know, when he embraces you and you're walking in God's path and God's word and you're living for God, you are a radiant being that people want a piece of that, and they want to be like, I want what that person has. I want to be filled with the Holy Spirit. I want what they have in their lives. Just without saying anything, you can be a blessing to someone, but even more so by sharing the word of God. So if your light is shining and someone says they want a piece of that, that's what we're supposed to do, share that light. Share a little bit of your testimony, a little bit of the background of where you came from, but glorify God and where you are today.
Amen.
And that's what they want to hear. I'm so blessed. This week I've really been praising the Lord and thanking him. I'm doing a lot of thanking him for everything that he's given to us and me personally, because where I've come from, I was blessed as a child to be brought up in a Christian home and then fell away. But God is so forgiving, and he will bring you back to where you are and beyond.
Yes.
And bless you, you know, to the ends of the earth. He just pours out. I mean, we ask for one little thing. Lord, give us a little building that we can put all of our stuff in and meet people out of. And this is what he gave us.
Amen.
He didn't start somewhere with a little bitty, you know, yes, I had this at my home, and that's kind of what it looked like back there. But, you know, he came from that. It didn't go to another little building and another little building. God went big.
Yes, he did.
I mean, we had 100 parking spots out there.
We got the coolest parking lot in town.
So don't dream small.
That's right.
Dream big.
Amen.
And use those dreams to bless others.
Yes.
Like this week, God's really been pouring out blessings on us so that we can bless others. Right. And that's what this ministry is about. It's not about Chuck and I doing this and that, and you guys are helping. That's not what it is. It's everybody together.
Amen.
Being a blessing to each other and then sharing that outside of the world.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Good stuff, Daddy.
Yeah, you know, and when we get to hand out food all throughout the week, man, there are people that want us to pray for them. They are just so thankful of what they're getting, you know, and it just blows my mind that the Lord just keeps on, just like I said, we can't give it away fast enough. You know?
Well, thank you, Lord.
It's funny, as soon as we get it cleaned up and everything looks good, get everything put up, here comes a big load. It's like, but a couple of them's going to be a disaster. A tornado went through.
It's a work of love, honey. It's a work of love.
You're going to be completely messed up.
Yeah.
Constantly changing.
And we are going to get our schoolrooms back going. We got it. As soon as we... these people gave us another storage building. We're going to put it out front and get all of our Christmas and Halloween, Thanksgiving and all that stuff,
decorations
out of all the places, and then
we can
open up
some classrooms. And we have a storage building that we pay $74 a month for. It's full of stuff that we haven't looked at in months.
Yeah, we're going to be getting rid of a bunch of stuff. I need to give with her some restaurant equipment. I'll be getting rid of some things that you need. That's our goal, is to get rid of that $78 a month bill there for that storage.
Amen.
And it's just tables and chairs and stuff that we don't need, because the fold-up tables do exactly what we need. We get to have chairs and we put out the eating area. I know it's a little work on Sunday, but
It's all right, man. It gets us all working together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we can eat. And we will be getting back to eating. So I'm excited about that. I miss all that barbecue and chicken. So, but from now on, for just another week, hopefully, we'll be just feeding out there. I'm gonna work hard to try to get this done, get Norm inside before he freezes out there serving the poor guy. And I'm believing. I think if we do it cautiously and we wear our mask when everybody that is a volunteer here and being responsible. And we might even have to have people Monday through Friday when they come in to wear masks, because we are feeding people that are in really high risk areas that come in here. And a lot of them are from all over this place, you know. So we probably will have to have masks and stuff. And it doesn't make sense to me. You got to make them wear a mask, but when you sit down and eat, you got to take it off. Right? It's like, come on. Yeah. I don't really get it.
So,
yeah, we'll figure it out. And it's going to be a learning thing. But I'm really excited to get back inside, man. I'm tired of that. That was hot last year. And if anybody needs prayer, toss your hand up. And before we pray, I do.